Okay, student, today we will discuss concept of database approach and advantage of database approach. In last class we discussed concept of traditional file processing systems. Now we see that why we are having the concept of the database approach. Why we need the concept of the database approach. First, we see that we are having the different drawback in the traditional file processing system. First one is the data is in traditional file processing system, data is embedded with application programs rather than stored separately and independently. So to overcome the problems of data is embedded with the application programs. Data dependency. To overcome the problems of data dependency, we are using the concept of database approach. First, and next one we see that second one is that there is no control over the access and manipulation of the data in traditional file processing system. So because of these two main issues, data dependency and no control over the access and manipulation of the data in traditional file processing system, database approach was introduced. Database approach emphasizes the integration and sharing of the data throughout the organization. In database approach, we are having the concept of the centralized storage of the data. Data is stored at a single point for all the organization and department. And that is a self-describing collection of integrated data. Database approach removes all the drawback of the file processing. Now we are having the concept of advantages of the database approach. First one, we are having the data independency. As you say that in traditional file processing system, let me show you the diagrams of the database approach. In database approach, we are having the concept of different sections are available: library section, examination section, registration section. Application programs are available for library section, for examination section, and for the registration section we are having the different applications. Then we are using the database management system, that is a software, and then we have to store the data at the centralized locations, right? So here we say that data independency, application programs and file description are not embedded to each other. Data is stored separately and application programs are deleted separately. That is the first one, that data independency. What is the data independency? Separation of the data description from the application program. That is called data independency. Data descriptions are stored at the centralized location, and that one location is called repository. Now, next one, we are having the plain data redundancy. Redundant data duplication. Data is stored at the one point at the centralized locations. Different applications have to access the data from the centralized locations: library, examinations, or any other application is there. Different users are there. They can access the data from the centralized locations. So there is no duplication of the data in database approach. single centralized database is used for all the department. So there is no need to store same data at the different locations. When we are having the data at one point, then it improves the data consistency. Data will be available at one point. If we want to make any changes in the data, we need to make changes at one point or single point. That is the improved data consistency. Then another improved data sharing. So here we see that data again is stored at the centralized location. Different user can access the data from the centralized location, and those users are authorized users, are having the permissions to access the data using the ground. Admin users have to authorize the different user so that they may be able to access the data. Next one, we are having the concept of increased productivity of application development. That it reduces the times and the cost of the development the new business applications. How? We see that data store at one point. Data storage will be done just once. Many meters of data, that will not take too much time. If we are having already application is there, we don't need the new application from the scratch. So that's why it increases the productivity. It takes very less time for developing the new business application. It improves the data quality. Different type of the constraints. What is the constraint? Different set of rules that are used to maintain the accuracy of the data. Set of rules that no one may be able to violate those rules that improve the quality of the data. Like in database approach, we see that ID value must be unique. Student ID value can't be repeated. Right? We are having the primary key constraint. We are having check constraint. We are having unique constraint. We are having null constraints and so many other constraints we will discuss later on. Then we are having the improved data accessibility and the responsiveness. To access the data and retrieve the data in database approach become very easy because of the database management systems. In database management system, different user use structured query language. Using structured query language, user can access the data very fastly and accurately. Next advantage, that is the program maintenance. Program maintenance that include adding the new data, adding new data items, types, making any changes in the data types, make change in the formats, make change in the size, like that one. That is related to the program maintenance. As in database approach, we are using again structured query language. Using those language, we may be able to perform the maintenance operations. And we have in application programs, different database applications and database approach changes either in application programs or the data that done without affecting the other factors. Then next one, improve decision support. So data warehouse is used for the decision making process in the database approach. These are the few advantages of the database approach. This one is example diagram we already discussed. Now we are having the different type of the cost and risk that are involved with the database approach. For implementation of the database approach, we need new and specialized personnel are needed. We have to hire employee. Similarly, we have to install and the management cost and complexities, installations of the different DBMS software, management cost are needed. Then we are having the conversion cost, then need for explicit backup and recovery, and then we are having the organization conflict. Now next one is database management systems. What is the database management system? DBMS, database management system, is a software that is used to create, maintain and provide control access to the user of database. So database management system is a software that is used to create the database, create the different type of the different database objects, maintain those objects and provide the control access to the user of the database. We are having the different user of the database. Those users can be end user, administrator users or developers. So DBMS provide control access to the user of database. DBMS, we are having the different DBMS like Oracle, SQL Server, MySQL, PostgreSQL and so many others. DBMS provide environment that is convenient and user can efficiently use that those DBMS. Thanks for watching the video. Have a nice